and welcome to CSIRO Pod. I'm Glenn Paul. I'm in Perth in Western Australia at CSIRO's Floreat Laboratories, where I'm going to meet a scientist who's researching the health benefits of lupins. But not just doing that in the laboratory, but also in the kitchen.
Dr. Rhonda Foley is a plant biologist and amateur chef who's researching lupins, a relative of soybean, and a valuable source of protein and dietary fibre.
We've always known that lupin is a healthy food in that it has high fibre, it has high protein content, and very low starch, so it'll be an ideal diet for those who require a gluten-free diet. But what's really interesting is how healthy lupins are. For example, they're great against heart disease, as well as they're great for those who have diabetes, and also they have satiety properties. That is, that if you eat lupin, you become more full and subsequently eat less the next meal. For example, if you have lupin bread for breakfast, you'll eat less calories for lunch.
The CSIRO team have identified 16 genes which may provide a key into why lupin is so healthy. The job now is to identify which of these genes are involved in the health benefits of lupins.
So that's the science behind lupin. Now let's see how we can use lupins in the kitchen. So today I'm going to make a tasty Mediterranean pizza, which includes 50% lupin flour and 50% wholemeal flour.
The process from here of mixing, cutting and dicing took about 30 minutes.
And this is the final product, our lupin Mediterranean pizza. And while it may look small, it's actually enough to feed two adults, partly because of the satiety properties of lupin. That is, if you eat lupin, you feel full afterwards. Now, let's put this in the oven. So in half an hour, we'll have a healthy, yummy pizza.
So there certainly is a lot going for lupins. And if you'd like to find out more about the research and have a look at the recipe for that pizza, just visit our website at www.csiro.au.